In this video, we're looking at a projectile motion problem where the main goal is to find the launch angle. And what we know about the impact in this problem is a little bit unusual. We're told that it runs into this vertical cliff face exactly at the top of its trajectory. So at the top of the trajectory, we see this horizontal final velocity because we're at the transition between the projectile moving up and moving down, and that means the y velocity is zero. So that's a key piece of information here, so we'll put in a little note. Vy equals zero at the impact. So we start analyzing the problem, and the first thing to get done is to break our initial velocity into its x and y components. So V0x, the initial x velocity, is going to be our initial speed, which was 68 meters per second, times the cosine of this unknown launch angle, theta. V0y is similar, and that's 68 times the sine of theta. And so to get this problem done, we're going to have to use the information we have about the impact, which is that the y velocity is zero there, and we're going to have to incorporate some analysis of the x direction and the y direction. So if I just start by looking at what's going on in the x direction, that motion is described by the simple kinematics equation x equals x naught plus v naught x t. And that's because the x velocity of a projectile is constant, so there's no acceleration term in this equation. We're going to put our origin at the original position of the projectile, and that means x naught is zero. So now if I plug in my final position, and we were told here that the cliff is 85 meters away from where we launched this thing, so I plug in 85, and then we go ahead and put in v naught x as 68 cosine theta, and then we have an unknown flight time left over. So this is one equation with two unknowns in it. That's theta and t. And of course, we're going to get a second equation by continuing the analysis in the y direction. So if your first thought is to use the y position equation, so there's that, y equals y naught plus v naught yt minus 1/2 gt squared. This equation introduces another unknown that we don't want to get involved in. So this has the final y position in it, which is another unknown in the problem, and that's not going to be fruitful for us. What we want is an equation that includes the final y velocity because we're going to plug in the fact that that's equal to zero, and we don't want to introduce any more unknowns, so we don't want the final height in our equation. All we have to do is look at the equation describing the y velocity. So that's Vy is V naught y plus acceleration times time, which is minus gt in this case because the y acceleration is negative g. Plugging in our final y velocity, that's zero. And then our initial y velocity, that was a 68 sine theta. And I'll go ahead and just put numbers in at this point for g. So I have negative 9.8 times t. So there's a second equation with two variables in it, theta and t. Now we know in principle we can solve this problem because we have two equations and two unknowns, but it does involve trig functions, which makes it a little bit harder than usual. So what I'm going to do is solve the y equation for t, and then we'll sub that value into the x equation. So when I solve the y equation for t, I'm just going to add 9.8t to both sides and then divide by 9.8. I'll go ahead and combine the numbers out in front of the sine function. So that's 68 divided by 9.8. And I'll just keep a lot of precision as I go here. So this gives me 6.939 times the sine of theta. Now our goal is to sub that in to the x equation. So the x equation then gives us 85 is equal to 68 cosine theta times 6.939 sine theta. So I'll go ahead and multiply the 68 and the 6.939, and we arrive at this equation. 85 is 471.84 cosine theta sine theta. And we're trying to solve for theta, but it's stuck inside two different functions, and that's a problem. However, we do have a trig identity for 2 times sine times cosine. That's going to simplify to the sine of 2 theta. So what I'm going to do is pull a 2 out of my 471.84, so I just divide that by 2. That gives me 235.92. And what I'm left with is 2 times the cosine of theta times the sine of theta, which simplifies to the sine of 2 theta. Now we can solve for the sine of 2 theta by dividing by 235.92. That gives us sine of 2 theta is 0.3603. All right, so 2 theta is the angle whose sine is 0.3603. And that gives us 21.12 degrees. Finally, all we have to do is divide by 2, and we have our launch angle. And to 3 significant digits, this comes out to 10.6 degrees. Now the follow-up question in part B is actually really simple by comparison. We're asked to find the impact speed with the cliff if we use this launch angle. And because the impact is totally horizontal at the top of the trajectory here, our final velocity at the impact, just showing this as a vector, is the same as the initial x velocity vector because the y component of the motion is zero at that point. So this x velocity never changes. So the x velocity at the impact is the same as it was at the beginning. And this means our speed, which I'll write as a v with no vector over the top, is going to be 68 cosine of theta. And we just found that as about 10.6 degrees. And this gives us an impact speed of 66.8 meters per second. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.